Hi everyone, this is Grace. How are you? You know, we would live up to age 100 and we would be working until age 80. So let's redesign your life. Today, I'd like to talk about my definition of wealth and the importance of self-branding. What is wealth? It is very personal. Many people name wealth being a physical abundance. For instance, they would say, oh, I'd like to have six-figure income. I'd like to have seven-figure income. I wish to see seven-figure millions of dollars in my savings account. I'd like to move into a big, huge house or mansion with the ocean view, or I'd like to drive luxurious car, supercar, German car, and I like to send my kids to most prestigious private school, and so on and so on. I'd like to have a vacation in Europe or Africa, safari, and so forth, so forth. And I might be wrong, but to tell you the truth, I think those people who say that's the definition of their wealth, most likely they don't have that. That's why they wish to have those things that they don't have. Then how about for those of us who already have those lifestyle that people only dreamed about? Then what would be wealth for those physically affluent people? Then they would say something about emotional or psychological wellness. For instance, as I always say, the real happiness is the good balance of love, health, and money. So let's say you're already blessed with lots of money, but what if your marriage is broken? What if your family is broken? Or your health? Yeah, you have money, you have happy marriage, happy family, but you are sick. You are very, very sick, frail. You really cannot enjoy what you have, right? So I believe you need to have those three balances. But I feel what is most important to you, what should be the definition of wealth to you, is what you have left after you have lost everything. That's exactly what I experienced when I was 25 years old. I lost my job. I lost my hospital job to take care of my father, who suddenly became sick and he had to go under emergency surgery. Back then in the United States, they didn't have family leave of absence. They only had maternity leave of absence. So from Japan, I called my boss. I asked, could I have a couple of months on the leave? You don't have to pay me, but I just like to stay in Japan to take care of my father. My boss said, Grace, can you come back tomorrow? Or please turn in letter of resignation. So at that moment, I thought my career was shattered. I thought my life was finished because I thought I was the cream of the crop, went to the good universities, had a good job, everything, but suddenly my income stopped, my lifestyle stopped. I thought that was the end of it, but that was the best lesson I had in my life. I realized, yes, my cash flow stopped, my job is gone, my status is gone, but I still had good health, I still had loving and optimistic husband. He and I were optimistic. We believe what we can do. We believe our future and our potential. And we just shift our mind. And you know, the rest is a history. We struggle, but we made it through. And today, some people dream about our type of lifestyle. So we were very blessed. So this is what I'm saying. The true wealth is something you have left. when you have lost everything. So it's not the money in your bank account. It's not the house you live in. It's not the car you drive. But you still have all the knowledge, wisdom in your brain. And you have your loving family or your loving friends. You have a friendship, right? And your trust. Your trust and integrity is the real asset you have. Because that's what my husband and I have. We have integrity. So no matter how many times we go under, people knows what kind of business we do. People knows what kind of integrity we have. And the people know we are a person of action. We don't just talk, but we do deliver. We take action. We do our best. Sometimes we do make a mistake, but we do our best and we are honest and we have integrity. That is my biggest asset. So what I'm saying is you need to really cherish your self-branding. You know, what is self-branding? Some people try to have lots of fillers, try to have lots of lies, but people can tell you are lying. People can tell you are genuine. And then, you know, I don't like new rich people, or I don't like those people. Suddenly, you know, used to be so poor, and suddenly they got the cash, and they act out as though they are the center of the world. I hate those people because they are not sincere, they are not honest, and they don't have integrity. I just hate people who don't have integrity. So suddenly, lots of cash, now start fooling around with, you know, women, have affairs. I hate them. They never earn my respect. So same is true for you. Don't just pick the friends or don't choose any investment or people because it's gonna give you immediate money or profit or a short-term profit, okay? You have to be very careful to select your friends. Select who you would hang out with because, you know, people of the same, like-minded, they tend to get together. So if the person is a sneaky con artist or a fake person or a liar, they tend to get connected. Or let's say if you don't have any experience, let's say if you are naive, if you are not street smart, but don't get attracted to those fake people. No, those people who say, fake it till you make it, oh, I hate those people. They are fakers. And don't you ever hang out with the people who fake it until they make it. Because you better not fake yourself. Just follow your heart. It's okay, you are too honest. Like me, sometimes I'm too honest. I don't play the game. I say it if I don't like you. I say if you are wrong, I speak up. And I wouldn't want to do business with you if you are a con artist, if you're a liar, or you're a fake person. So I may not have a flashy life, but it's okay. I feel best because I can sleep well at night because I'm always authentic. I don't tell a lie. So I can sleep well. And that is my life. I want to sleep well at night, and I want to be happy at heart, and I always follow my heart. I want you to be that way. That will be your self-branding, and that is your strength. That will be your asset when you lose everything. But if people know you, you as a person of integrity and honesty, don't worry. You can always be back on your feet. Okay, that's all for today. Take care of your self-branding. Follow your heart. Your action should be based upon what is good, what is wrong. Not what makes money and what is non-profit, you know. Okay, that's all for today. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.